up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. If this is your first time on the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so that you're notified anytime something comes up on the channel. It has been a minute since we jumped on a vlog together and produced some content, and one of the big reasons is we just had our beautiful baby boy. And up till the point he was born, even to when he was born until now, it has been absolutely hectic in our lives. And just trying to find some time to get to some more race car stuff. Right now it's not very priority for us because we do have a son now, so we have to start focusing on him. Still trying to figure out how to get into the routine of sleep, feed, and being awake, so bear with us. I'm gonna try and get you guys some more content as soon as I can. Today is January 2nd of 2022, so hopefully you guys had a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and this is gonna be the first one of the year. We are getting started for all of the 2022 prep at this point. And the first thing that we have decided to address is under the engine bay. And Holley Performance has sent us some great parts to put under the hood of this car to make it look much, much cleaner and much nicer. So we'll go open the hood of the old girl, and I'll kind of show you what we're gonna do here. So under the hood, you can see we have plenty of Holley bits already. We've got the Holley high ram, the 105 throttle body. We have all of the Holley front mid-mount accessory kit. The whole wiring harness and engine computer is the Holley Terminator X. It was super simple to put on, just plug and play. And so far, that system has worked flawlessly for us. We recommend it to anyone. If you're interested in the Terminator X, I'll go ahead and link that down below, as well as all the other Holley parts that I have on this car, including the high ram, the throttle body, the accessory kit. What Holley sent us that we will be addressing in this video is getting rid of this ugly stuff here. Although this is kind of an option that a lot of people do, we want to get rid of this because we have been burning through some plug wires, mainly just this one, and we want it to look a little bit nicer and also keep from burning this plug wire. So what we are going to end up doing, Holley has sent us out some new valve covers. And this will be the first part of the puzzle. And the valve covers we chose to go with were the Tall LSX satin black valve covers. I will link these in the description below. But this is gonna make this look so much cleaner because we're gonna get rid of those coil brackets and the coils on top. So when we do that, we're gonna have to have a place to relocate these coils. And instead of relocating these old factory coils, Holley has sent us out some MSD Blaster coil packs. And these are obviously going to be a high performance reliability option for us. So glad to have these MSDs versus the stock coils. I think we're gonna get much more reliability out of these. I have gone through a couple of stock coils already. This is gonna hopefully eliminate all of that and also give us the performance we want for the car. And to mount these to the car, Holley has also sent us the Sniper EFI LS coil relocation bracket set. Part number is here, which I will also link in the description in case any of you are interested in doing this yourselves. But this is gonna be a nice little tidy bracket set for us to use and put somewhere in the engine bay of the car out of the way so that it looks much more tidy. And then of course, we're also gonna have to have new plug wires that are long enough to go from the plugs themselves all the way to the coil packs that are gonna be remote mounted. So we're gonna need quite a long set of wires. So what they've done is they've sent me the Axcel Extreme 9000 ceramic boot plug wires, and these are actually very long and you create them yourself. The reason why we wanted to go with these is because these boots on the ends, not only can you get different angles on them, but they are ceramic, which basically means that they're kind of like a glass instead of like the old rubber style. So they are less susceptible to burning, which is what we really want. Now we have put these Axcels on here already. These are currently those Axcels just in black, but we do not have one for the back because we didn't have the correct bend. So far so good, these sit perfectly inside the headers so that they aren't getting burnt. Like I said before, it's just mainly this back one, but I think if we just get rid of all this, it's just gonna look so much better. And last but not least, this is the current harness for the ignition coils from the Terminator X harness. And what we're gonna have to do in order to make it fit where we want it to, which is most likely gonna be over here, we're gonna have to have an extension harness. So Holley has sent me this extension harness for both banks. So obviously these will be linked in the description below because you will absolutely have to have these in order to run the remote mount coil setup. What this is gonna do is it's gonna plug into our current harness, and then it's gonna run down this side to the harness that we have on top of the coils at the moment. So I know that was a ton of information, but I think this is gonna look amazing once we get it all finished. So I'm gonna go ahead and get cracking. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this a two-part video. The first part, we're gonna do the valve covers and the coil pack relocation. And then in part two, we're gonna mess with the wires, get those run, because we will have to make those wires ourselves. That could be a little time consuming. So we'll do that for part two of this video, but let's get started. That one is off. Simple enough. Now I believe I'm gonna have to take this harness off so that I can keep all the coil pack individual plugs on this harness. This is kind of an older harness, so I may end up getting a new one of these. I didn't think about it until just now, but this is a little bit old, and I actually have two of these for each side if needed, but I'm just gonna go ahead and use this one for now, and then I may, like I said, just go ahead and get some more coming and then put them on at a later date. This is actually gonna be the first time that I've put these since building the engine. So I'm kind of excited to see what it looks like in here. Man, it's still so clean in there. Holy cow. It's amazing, and look. These are the factory valve covers, and look how clean they are. I'm super impressed with how clean this is. This is how clean the inside of this valve train is. I mean, this has been a whole season of just bashing this car. And also, we have been running Amsoil Dominator in this the entire time. And I'm super pleased with that. So I'm gonna have to hit them up to get some more product. I'm gonna go ahead and get the gasket put on this new valve cover and get it set in there, tighten her down. So one thing the instructions say to do is reuse these stock gaskets that you currently have. These, like I said, only have a season on them. So I am not opposed to using these at all. They still look good. I don't see any tears. So we're gonna just use these, put them in there, and then throw her on. The original hole is right here. There it is. Yeah, it's a little difficult to get it in there, the original hole, but just feel your way around in there and you'll get it. It's hard because you can't see in there. It does look like they have changed the sizing to a 9, so you may need to get a 9mm. As opposed to the factory 8mm. So we're going to just get these snug for now. These don't have to be tightened very tight anyway, but we're just gonna snug them up for right now just to keep them on, and then we'll go back in and torque them to the spec later. Sick, now this is on there, looks amazing. It's gonna make this engine bay look so much cleaner. Looks much better than this side already. Super, super happy with it. Now to basically figure out where we're gonna put our coil packs. And I think that I'm going to put them over here. I think that's gonna be the easiest place. You can't put them over here because we do have our fuel pressure regulator and our brake reservoir over here. So it's gonna be kind of impossible to put them here, but I think that I can get them to fit here. So what I'm gonna do is take these brackets out of the box, take the coil packs out of the box, mount them up, and then see how they look over there. So let's do that real quick. All right, so what I've done to kind of mock everything up, I've taken the coil harness off of the factory coils, just kind of plugged them in here so we can see how much room we're gonna have to have. And then I got into the plug wire kit that I got and put these 90s on the top so that we know how tall it's gonna sit. The idea place is for it to sit back here. So I'm gonna go ahead and thread that down inside there. And it looks like the only way we're gonna get this to fit is if we put it at an angle, kind of like this. I could possibly get it to fit straight. I would just need to take this off of here, which would not be a huge issue. I just couldn't use the shocks anymore, which would kind of suck, but then again, race car, so I could use a hood prop, no big deal. I think what I'm going to do is just kind of put them at a slight angle like this. You can see it's not completely straight, but I think that's gonna work for us. So what I'm gonna do is basically take off the inner two, because underneath here are the screw holes to where I can maybe put some self-tappers in. It does fit down here very snug, but it does work. So I'm not worried about that. Mounted with the self tapper and the washer that they provided with the bracket. So now the thing I have to do next is just mount all of those coils back on here with the supplied bolts. Now we'll be ready to rip, plug them into the existing coil harness here, and then that's done. And then all that's left is the plug wires. Now the only thing to do is to make sure that the hood closes properly. This sits a little lower than even with this gasket, and I don't think that the hood goes any further down than this gasket does. So I'm gonna go ahead and lower the hood down and see what we come up with. All right, so that didn't go as planned. Thing is, this actually sits down in here. So at this point, we're gonna have to abandon hood shocks, which isn't a bad thing, like I said before. Well, we don't have to have hood shocks, luckily, because race car. So we could just take the hood shocks off and start using something to prop the hood up. That's no big deal. I've got plenty of broom handles. Or the thing that I would like to do most, but obviously it costs quite a bit of money, is get a fiberglass hood for the car and have it latch at all four corners. Then we just pull the hood off whenever we need to lift the hood or look under the hood. So that would be the ideal scenario, but that is a lot of money. So this time I'm just gonna go ahead and pull the hood shocks off. They're not used anyway, they're busted. So no big deal there, like I said. That will give us plenty of clearance. The hood, I believe, will shut if it wasn't for that. So I think we're gonna be in good shape once we do that.
So yeah, we have a hood prop. It's a paint stick for a brush roller. Sweet. So here you can see the issue that I was having. That just drops down right there, and that's as far down as it goes. So I'm gonna have to work with this, take this little guy off right here, which isn't a huge deal. I'm gonna go ahead and get that off, and then we should be clear to shut it down.
And the last step to the puzzle here was hooking up the extension harness, which I've tucked over here in the corner, ran it up around through here to where it's kind of staying up above everything. And it comes in right through here underneath the intake manifold, and then I have it plugged in right there under there so that the plug is out of the way of everything. What I'm gonna do is grab some zip tie all this up to this fuel line so that it kind of stays out of the way at all times, and then that part will be done.
Super stoked. This is gonna look awesome once it's all done. Can't wait to get the plug wires and everything on there. That's gonna be in the next video, but obviously I'm gonna replicate everything I've done on this side of the car to the other side. Everything should work exactly the same because both sides of the car are identical as far as the fender wells go. So should not be an issue there. And then in the next video, we're gonna tackle putting the plug wires together and then making them long enough to reach over to the coils. So hopefully you guys got some value out of this video. Be sure and check out Holley Performance online. I have linked all of the parts that I've used in this video down below. If you have an LS and you'd like to remote mount the coil packs, this is everything that you're gonna need in order to do that. And kind of give you an idea of maybe where you can put yours. If you have an E36 chassis, you can basically just use everything that I've used. Or if you have somewhere else you'd like to mount it that I was not able to, there you go. But all this stuff should work for what you're doing. I wanna give a massive shout out to Holley Performance for sending us these parts to make the engine bay look so much better. But that's gonna do it for this one, guys. And we will see you on the next one. See ya.